Hello, namaste. Very good evening and welcome to Chit Media and the Festival of Bharat. Today we are joined by somebody really special. She's an author of several books and she's introduced history and traditions in the right way to a lot of people who are reading her books today. Please join me in welcoming Sai Swarupa Iyer ji. Namaste ji, how are you?
Namaste Sharan, I'm good. How are you?
And I'm really good
very
too.
Happy 2022.
Thank you so much. You're the first person I'm interviewing in 2022, and I know it is going to be an awesome year because of that. First of all, let me ask you, you know, looking at the kind of books you do, have your own niche that you've carved out, and you're trying to be as creative and as approachable as possible, even to youngsters who want to learn about a lot of our own traditions and history, right? And it's not an easy thing to get them to be interested in many of these subjects. So what led to you, you know, to your focus on this particular category of writing?
Interesting question. I keep wondering about the same thing about, what exactly keeps me going, because I grew up with these stories. Firstly, I grew up with Ramayana. I grew up with Mahabharata more than Ramayana and all kinds of stories, and it's not just the religion part of it that attracted me. Of course, there is, and our religion has so many wonderful, beautiful things which keeps us going, dharma. But it is the whole package, if I can use the word, of adventure, romance, as well as dharma, all of it, bound by the tenets of dharma. And the most beautiful thing is definition of dharma keeps dynamically changing. Right. It's always like an evergreen puzzle to find out what is dharma for, right. Not just for us, but even for the great people of our ancient past, it has always been that riddle of to find out what is their dharma and whatever they can do to.
You mean to say that individually we have our own understanding of it? Because very recently somebody asked me if I was dharmic, and dharmic in what sense? So it was very difficult for me to define. Of course, I'm a dharmic person in terms of I go to temples, I follow all the traditions. But of course, there are no set parameters in Sanatana Dharma, right? It's not like saying if you don't follow this, you don't become a Hindu.
That's why, the way Sanatana Dharma is very liberal in judging a person, right? Because it believes in that journey. So people are free to make their own journey of realization at their own pace.
Right.
Commit themselves and stand by it, which is why Sanatana Dharma allows us that leeway, right? And coming to your question about what made me write this subject. So yes, I told you I grew up with these stories, and somewhere without my conscious effort, Mahabharata especially became a sort of a family. I could feel kinship with the Pandavas, Arjuna in specific, especially during my student days. And that's what, there was some kind of a bond that kept me going through a lot of tough phases. So, those fusion phases where I moved from a small town to a big city, the culture shock in the late teens.
Right.
And then the whole onslaught of academia, the career, everything. At every twist and turn, I think I clung to Mahabharata.
Right.
I clung to Krishna. And that's what kept me going during all tough phases, which is why I just feel like, I have a duty to share the stories from our ancient past. Not just Mahabharata, but as and when I keep discovering these wonderful stories, I just... Yeah. Find it as my calling to share them, as I felt the same bonding. I would like my readers to feel the same bonding.
Please remember to subscribe to us and switch on the notifications for this channel. For our other social media links, more content, and to support our work, please visit citti.net. Dhanyavad. Namaskar.